The ANC says it will humble itself and reimburse government the cost of the flight to Zimbabwe on a military jet. Now, the governing party says members of the delegation led by ANC Secretary General Ace Magashule are in quarantine as per lockdown regulations. This follows widespread outrage over the use of SANDF resources by the African National Congress. Now, for more on this, I'm joined in studio by Newsroom Africa's politics editor, Sbu Ngalwa. Good to have you with us once again, Sbu. I was literally speaking to Opa Sekgalwe when the news broke, and the details at that point were still, sketchy, at least on my side, as to exactly what has the ANC decided. But yes, it is confirmed. It was released in a press statement as part of a report back of how the Zimbabwe situation went. Right at the bottom, a paragraph saying that they are going to reimburse government. Tell us more about that and the reasons why.
Well, I think the statement was more about what they've decided to do rather than the report back on the Zimbabwe trip. Because if you look at the statement, it doesn't give much detail except to say that they had a very cordial discussions with their Zimbabwean counterparts, which is the ZANU-PF, and that the ANC officials had been briefed by Ace Magashule on the trip. But the reality is that I think this was embarrassing for the ANC, and they realized that they cannot avoid culpability. But I think more than anything, it shows that from the very beginning, a lack of foresight on the part of the ANC leaders, where they could, because ordinarily they should have foreseen that it would get to this point where South Africans would be clamoring and calling for accountability on the part of the ANC. So decision to suddenly reinvest the money, it actually, more than anything, is actually the ANC admitting that it was wrong for them to actually abuse state resources and be part of that trip. But I think for the public protector, it makes perfect sense for her to continue the investigation, because the investigation is around the abuse of state resources. She's not investigating the ANC, but the Department of Defense, where the Minister of Defense has to explain how she got to carry her comrades, for lack of a better words, to give them a lift to Zimbabwe.
It's really about processes, right? And to see where the leaks are so that those leaks can then be adequately addressed. Now, the question that South Africans might be wondering is, had South Africans not caused a hullabaloo about the mode of transport in this particular instance, you know, what else could actually happen and fall through the cracks if there is no public vigilance, if there is no public outcry? And I guess that's the question here.
Well, Tami, this is about accountability. And South Africans are within their rights to demand that of their government. We are a constitutional democracy, and we have laws in this country that govern how we live and what laws to observe. And we know that we are under a lockdown, and there are certain protocols that are in place in terms of who can leave the country and come into the country and under what circumstances. So all at a primary level, it looks like all those rules were broken in this instance. So in terms of the minister, because it's clear now that the minister, yes, did have authority to travel to Zimbabwe, but the question is how the ANC delegation got to be part of this. Because this is not about the state. And the point is simple, that the president has envoys that he can send to Zimbabwe that are part of that can use a military jet, but not a party, not the ANC. But what it goes to, I mean, at the heart of it, is actually the arrogance of the ANC over time, where they believe themselves to be above the laws that govern everyone, regardless of what the ANC said. I think that that idea is still far entrenched within the party, where they think that they can just use a military plane to fly to Zimbabwe and to talk to a sister organization.
And I guess also the question of separation of party and state here, and where do you draw the line between the two? But we'll leave it at that for now, Sbu. Lovely chatting to you once again. That's Sbu Ngalwa, our politics editor. The latest breaking news there, the African National Congress saying that they will pay for their flights to Zimbabwe and reimburse the South African National Defense Force.